गुड मॉर्निंग। माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर रितेश कुमार सारस्वत, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन ईसी डिपार्टमेंट, एमएलबी टेक्सटाइल एंड इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेज, भीलवाड़ा। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द डेल्टा मॉड्यूलेशन। देयर इज अ अपग्रेडेड फॉर्म ऑफ द पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन। इन केस ऑफ पल्स कोड मॉड्यूलेशन, इट ट्रांसमिट ऑल द बिट्स विच आर यूज टू कोड द सैंपल। Hence, signaling rate and transmission channel bandwidth are large in case of PCM system, pulse code modulation system. To overcome this problem using delta modulation. In delta modulation, transmit only one bit per sample. Input signal m of t is approximated by step signal and step size is fixed. The difference between the input signal m of t and staircase approximated signal confined by the two levels that are plus s or minus s. If difference is positive, then approximated signal is increased by one step, that is plus s. Whereas the difference is negative, then it is reduced by one step, that is minus s. When step size is increased, it is represented by the 1 and transmitted the 1 bit. If step size is reduced, then transmitted 0. As seen in this figure, there is the analog continuous signal m of t, and the another waveform is the staircase waveform, that is the u of t. That is also known as the approximated signal. So basically there is the comparison between the m of t and the u of t. So when, as seen in this one first one section, when the u of t is increased as compared to m of t, next u of t decreases as compared to u of t. Because of that, u of t is approximated with the continuous signal m of t. So u of t is decreases, that means it is represented by the step size will be reduces. It is equivalent or represent the binary sequence 0. Next, to approximate the continuous signal, so the staircase approximation will be increases, that will be the increases. So increasing form, that means the step size will be increases, that is represented by the 1. Again, next is again increasing 1, again increasing 1, again increasing 1. When next is, it is decreases, it is decreasing by the step fixed step size s, that is represented by the 0. Next again increasing, that is the 1. So ultimately conclusion is that when the step size is increasing, that is represented by the 1. When the step size is reduced, that is represented by the 0. Next one slide will represent the DM transmitter, delta modulator transmitter section. It consists the accumulator. Accumulator is consisting the summer delay by the amount of TS, time delay of the TS, and the another section is the 1-bit quantizer that will represent or create the single bit as according to the size plus s for 1, minus s for 0. As shown in the figure, the summer in the accumulator add quantizer output, it may be plus s or minus s, with the previous sample approximation. This is provide the present sample approximation u of t equals to u of nts minus ts plus plus minus plus s. That is the summer is provided the plus minus s, adding this one and another one quantity u of n minus 1 ts. The one delay of the amount of ts is provided by the this one section. Okay, so the present sample u of nts equals to u of n minus 1 of ts, one time delay of ts, and b of nts. B of nts is related to the plus minus s, plus s for 1, minus s for 0. The previous sample approximation u of n minus 1 into ts is restored by delaying one sample time delay of ts. Error signal, and the another parameter is the error signal e of nts, basically the subtraction of m cap of nts from m nts. So m nts minus m cap of nts, that is equals to e of nts. Depending upon the sign of e of nts, one bit quantizer generate a output of plus s or minus s. If e of nts is positive, it will generate the plus s. One bit quantizer will generate the plus s. If e of nts is negative, it will generate a minus s. Plus s related to 1, minus s related to 0. So this one section or the working of the DM transmitter section. Next is the DM receiver section. As shown in the DM receiver, it is using accumulator and low pass filter. This is the accumulator and this one is the low pass filter. The accumulator generates the staircase approximation with delay of one sampling time period TS. It will generate the staircase approximation with the delay of the amount of TS. It is then added to the input signal. If input is binary 1, then it add plus 1. If input is binary 1, that means it will add the plus s. If the input is binary 0, it will add the subtract the minus s. The low pass filter has the cutoff frequency. The output is transmitted to the low pass filter. The low pass filter has the cutoff frequency equal to highest frequency component in m of t. M of t is the input analog continuous time signal. Here is the considered in the second one slide. So the maximum frequency component, the cutoff frequency of the low pass filter is decided by the maximum frequency component in the m of t. This filter is using for smoothening the staircase signal to reconstruct the output m of t signal, output analog continuous time signal. Next we discuss the disadvantage of delta modulation. There are the two types of disadvantage or the two types of error are present in delta modulator. First one is the slow power load distortion and another one is the granular noise or granular distortion. In case of slow power load distortion, this type of distortion is generated when the rate of rise of input m of t signal, this one rate of rise of the input m of t signal is so high that the staircase signal cannot be approximated. This one staircase approximated signal is not approximated the or cover the this one signal of the continuous time signal. The step size has become too small for staircase signal to follow the step segment of m of t. Thus, there is a large error between the staircase approximated signal u of t and the original input signal m of t. This error is known as the slope overload distortion. When the slope rise of the slope of the m of t signal is higher, the staircase approximated signal will not cover this one. So this section will be represented by the slope overload distortion. And the second one part is the granular noise. Granular noise basically generated when the slope of the continuous time signal is decreasing rapidly, decreasing fastly as compared to decreasing the staircase approximation. This will be created the granular noise. So basically the slope overload distortion is created when the rise of the increasing of the slope of the m of t is higher. Granular noise is created when the slope of the continuous time signal is decreasing. And this one, these two errors basically are generated because of that. In case of delta modulator, there are the fixed step approximation. There are the step size is fixed. So fixed step size will not cover the or will not approximate the continuous time signal. So this type of error may be avoided by using the adaptive delta modulation. Basically adaptive delta modulation where the step size is variable as according to the slope of the m of t. Thank you.